This video ended up being about 30 minutes, so I actually split it up into two videos. The first one here you're going to watch is about the catalog pages and the indexes and how you get around the catalog pages. And then I'll have a second one about looking at the shopping cart and the checkout form. So enjoy the video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get around my shopping cart catalog pages and the shopping cart checkout screen, because sometimes people get lost and get confused, and I'm going to try to clear some of this up here. First of all, this is my homepage, hoffmanamps.com. What you see up here is a scrolling catalog of sorts with images, and clicking on any one of these pictures will take you to the catalog page for those items. Like this would take you to Pots and Knobs, and what this is down here is just you can go forward and backward with the scrolling, and these dots represent each page of the scrolling images. So all this is a navigator down here. Okay, so if you clicked on that one, you'd go to Tube Socket Pages. That's all this is up here. People like to look at pictures. Down below that here is a table, and this will take you to all these different pages in the catalog, just like the pictures up here will. So let's go into the catalog here. Let's say we want to go to Pots and Knobs here. So here's a typical catalog page. And what you have, let's start at the top up here. If you want to go to another catalog page, what we have here is indexes up here that are hidden so they don't take up a lot of space on your screens. So if you click that right there, click here to open the catalog index table. There's the table that'll take you to every catalog page plus other stuff. For example, I have a mobile user's catalog, and what it does is, I'll click on that. See, it puts everything down the middle of the screen and very friendly for small mobile devices. So you can click on any one of these images and it'll go to a mobile catalog page. If you want to get back to the non-mobile catalog, down below all that, you click on this, and you're back to an entry page to get there. So this opens up the catalog index like I showed you before. And if you like that scrolling picture index, that's right here. And here's how you close both of them. Let's go back to the regular catalog index table. And I already showed you what mobile users catalog can do. I have a neat little deal here where you can shop by photographs of items. So here's just images of the front of a vintage Fender. The red circles are around different items here, and if you clicked on this one, it would take you to Jack's. See that? This one would take you to Switches. There's a switch on the rear of a... So we're on the Switches page. This would take you to Tubes. Oh, Transformers down here. Capacitors, resistors, board parts. So anywhere you see one of these red areas, that will take you to that catalog page. So that's all that is a shop by photo page. And that's right here. Log in and log out. If you have previously checked out and created a username, you can log in to the shopping cart here or log out. And logging in grabs a hold of any previous discounts you've accumulated from previous orders. And also, if you're logged in, you can create private parts listings. So you could add a bunch of parts to the shopping cart and then save it as a private parts list. And you can have a bunch of different private parts lists. Say you do this one repair job over and over and over again, you use the same parts, you could create your own private parts list. And if you did that, you would go here and you would ask you to load a parts list. And I am already logged in and I only have this one parts list. But if you had multiples, they'd all show down below here. So I could change the quantity on this Alpha Amp parts. It's one 250K audio pot. And then click here to add it to the shopping cart. So that's what that is. I'll go back. Oh, let's go back here. All right, so we did all these. This is a kit's parts list page. And I have all these listings here that have all the parts to make these items. That I stock or don't even stock. I've got links to stuff I don't stock there. But let's say here's a Hoffman 5F Tweed Champ parts list. By the way, this is the link for every one of these that'll take you to my library page. Make sure you look at all the information for each one of these so you know what it is and know how to assemble it and read all the assembly documents. So, but anyways, let's go to a real short one like this. Let's just do this bias board because it's going to be a real short list of just a few pieces here. So now it took me to this page, which is all the parts for a generic fender bias board. And what you can do here is change any of the quantities you want here. Say you already have some of these ring terminals, you can change it to zero. And then add any non-zero items to your parts list. Actually, it's going to add it to your shopping cart there. Same thing. So if I click that, all of these parts up here would be added to the shopping cart automatically. And that's how parts list works. Okay. Let's go back here. I keep opening the index up here. So that was my parts list. Where did it private's parts list? This is just a quick search. You can search the catalog. Say I'm looking for turret lug. Turret lug. Search the catalog. These are all the pages where turret lug is mentioned. So some of it is just information, some of it is actually the page. Like this page is actually where the turret lugs are located. If I click that, take me to this page, which is the board building parts page. This one here. Okay. Down here are the turret lugs for the board material that I stock, which is right above it. So here's quantity items too. So any quantity from 1 to 499 are 15 cents each. But if you wanted 650, you would use this down here and change this to 650, and you would get them for 13 cents each. Let's say you wanted 1,209, you would get them for 11 cents each. So you use just one of these that's in the quantity range shown here. So that's how discount stuff works, and tall eyelets also have the discounts. So that's the board building page right there. And I did the search catalog. I've already added some items to my shopping cart. Here's how you get back to your shopping cart. Let's say you go to a page and it looks like this. How do I get back to my shopping cart? I've had people say, I don't know how to get back to my shopping cart. You open this. View your shopping cart. There's my shopping cart with all the stuff I've added. Now I'm going to get back to this in a minute here. I'm going to continue on with the menu items. And then we'll go to the cart there. So this one is if you created a custom board in DIY Layout Creator, you would go here. And you've already created the board. It sends you an email. And here's your file number, say. It's DIY998764. You'll get this number when you create the board and finish your custom board online. on my DIY file analyzer program. And I want one of them. You could put three in there if you wanted to. Add the custom board to shopping cart. It's just giving you a confirmation. Here's the customer's name and all that. All right. And here it is in my shopping cart. I've already added it previously. That's why, see, it's DIY board material. It's comprised of labor to drill 44 holes, 44 lugs, and install 44 lugs. So we're going to go back and continue on with the main menu there. So that was add custom boards. These are all regular catalog pages, board building I did. Here's where Hoffman turret boards are located. And make sure you go to the library page and look at all the info for each one of these boards so you know what you're getting, and read the install info, look at the layout diagrams, and the bill of materials. This link takes you to the library page. I'm going to go there and just show you what that looks like. And here is all the info for that board. Here's what people make the mistake of not doing. They just click on the part and order it, and they haven't even come here and looked at all the info. You need to do this first, then order the board. So here's a board with drilled holes only. Here is a board with turret lugs installed. So that's what these two columns are here. And this, if you click this, you can see an image of the board, what it looks like. So that's Hoffman turret boards. Now, if you're looking for fender style eyelet boards, these boards all follow the original fender layout. And you can get these drilled only for eyelets or eyelets installed, same as the turret lugs. And if you click on this one, doesn't have an actual picture of the board, it's just showing natural G10 colored board. Let me see here. Let's AB763 reverb board. There's one in natural. You can get them in black too. Okay, so Hoffman eyelet boards follow the original fender layout diagram. Hoffman turret boards are my own Hoffman layouts. And I've had people order a Hoffman turret board, say a 5E3 Deluxe, and go, hey, I don't understand the layout on this. Well, that's because you didn't go look at all the information. Click here to go look at the information, because Hoffman layouts are different. Even though it's a 5E3 Deluxe circuit, it's a different layout. It's not an original fender layout diagram. By the way, at every page here, this video you're watching right now, this link takes you back to this video, and you can rewatch it for tips on what I'm talking about right now. So it's nice to go back and refresh yourself with that. Okay, board building, we did that. Turret boards, eyelets, these are all regular catalog pages. This is a page that describes items I don't stock, like speakers and cabinets, stuff like that. If you want to know about how my discount program works, you can click here and go read about that. You have to have a username previously, and it saves up your sales, and you can get discounts on the total order, and you can apply it when you're checking out. That's how that works. Miscellaneous hardware, regular catalog. Here's a yard sale page. Sometimes stuff I'm blowing out, I'll blow it out for cost and put it on this page, so make sure you come here and check the yard sale page. And all the normal catalog pages usually have a link to get to your yard sale page here, just to remind you that, hey, there might be some goodies on the yard sale page. And I have a what's new page. This is, I'll put stuff that I recently added to stock here. And then you can click here and go right to the page where this item is located. That's all this is here. So if you haven't been here in a while, you can go, what's new? Oh, he's got F&T caps down here. go back to the catalog index here. All right, we've covered just about everything here. Let's just go to a regular page and add a part. Okay, I want this Fender two-button black pedal. I'm going to add it to my parts list. You can change the quantity here. Say you wanted three or four of these or five. Just do that and add it to your parts list. You can also rate parts here by giving them 1 to 5 stars. So if you click on this, it'll take you to a page where you can say, I'm giving this a 4-star or a 5-star or whatever. So let's add this pedal to the shopping cart. Now here is my shopping cart.